We discussed about the closure set of attributes. In this video, we'll discuss about the closure set of functional dependencies. So it is closure set of functional dependencies. Okay. Now, what is this closure set of functional dependencies? You can say if there are some functional dependencies which are already given. Now, from those functional dependencies, if you can find other functional dependencies which are also valid, then it is called as closure set of functional dependencies. Okay. So you can write it down like this. It is the set of all functional dependencies that can be determined by using the given set of functional dependencies, assume they are F, right? And it is denoted by F plus, or you can say F closure. Okay, so there's a difference between closure set of functional dependencies and closure set of attributes. In the previous video, we discussed about the closure set of attributes. So here in this video, we are discussing about the closure set of functional dependencies. Assuming that we have the relation R, A, B, C. This is a relation which is given. And this is the set of functional dependencies which are given. These functional dependencies are like this. A determines B and B determines C. Now, using these functional dependencies, what are the new functional dependencies you can find out? They are called as closure set. And if this is denoted by F, then this closure set will be denoted by F plus. And they can be anything. For example, here A can determine B, B can determine C, A can determine C, AC can determine BC, right? AB can determine BC, and so on. So there are so many functional dependencies you can find out. And all those extra functional dependencies are called as closure set of functional dependencies. Now let us see, assuming that this is a question. It is find the number of functional dependencies in F closure, which is determined by F plus, for a relation with two attributes. Okay, find the number of functional dependencies for a relation with two attributes. You can see, assuming that we have a relation R A comma B, that means these are the two attributes. First of all, take what are the possible subsets of this A and B. Right, so we are going to find the functional dependencies between X determines Y, where X can be a subset of A comma B and Y can also be a subset of A comma B. So how many subsets are possible? They are phi, A, B and AB. So phi is a subset of A comma B. Phi is a subset of this set which is containing A comma B. A is a subset of this set which is containing A comma B and so on. So there are four subsets you can have. Now here in this case, for Y also write all the subsets which are possible. So when we are trying to find the number of functional dependencies, that means we can have every functional dependency from this set to this set, right? So for example, if this set is containing four values and this set is having four values, so in total we will be having 4 into 4, that is 16 functional dependencies. So what came the formula here? For example, if a relation is given R and assuming that the cardinality of R is n, that means there are n attributes, then first of all you try to find the power set of R, and that power set will be containing 2^n attributes. For example, here there are 2, so there are 2^2, that means there are 4 subsets of this, and the Y will also be having 2^2, 2^n, so that is 2^n multiplied by 2^n, that means 2^2n. These many different functional dependencies are possible. For example, here you can see phi can determine phi. You can take a functional dependency like this. Phi can determine A, phi can determine B, phi can determine A comma B. In the same way, A can determine phi, A can determine A can determine B, A can determine AB, B can determine phi, B can determine B, B can determine A, B can determine AB, AB can determine phi, AB can determine A, AB can determine B, and AB can determine AB. So these are the possible functional dependencies which can have if we have a relation with two attributes, right? That means F plus is containing only 16 values. Okay, now coming back to the previous question here, we were having the original given functional dependencies are A determines B and B determines C. That means these are the functional dependencies which are already given, which are already given. Now when I'm saying F closure, or F closure means if we are trying to find what are the additional functional dependencies which holds, additional functional dependencies which hold, that means we have to take the closure set of this attribute and we have to find what are the functional dependencies which are actually valid for this. What are the functional dependencies which are valid? For example, if we have three attributes, then how many different functional dependencies are possible? If this is for x determines y, first of all try to find what is the cardinality of the power set of this. So cardinality of the power set will be 2 raised to power 3, that is we are having 8 subset of this. So what are those subsets? They are phi, A, B, C, AB, BC, AC, and ABC. These are the subsets of this. In the same way, y will be having phi, A, B, C, AB, BC, AC, and ABC. That means 8 into 8, you can see there are total 64 different functional dependencies are possible. Out of these 64 functional dependencies, we have to see how many functional dependencies are valid. How many functional dependencies are valid? To find how many functional dependencies are valid, we are going to take the help of these given functional dependencies. These given functional dependencies, right? So you can see with the help of these given functional dependencies, you can find so many new functional dependencies that will also be valid, and that is called as the finding what is the additional functional dependencies you can have. Okay, so let us do one thing. Let us take an example of this, because this example will become very huge, very large. So there's one more way of finding the additional functional dependencies, is that you take these attributes and you try to find the closure. For example, if I try to find the closure of A, then it will become B and C, that is ABC. That means A can determine A can determine B, A can determine C, A can determine AB, A can determine BC, A can determine AC, A can determine ABC, A can determine phi, right? Like this. So if you just take this one, then on this side we are having three attributes, so therefore 2 raised to power 3, yaniki, that means 8 different functional dependencies are possible from this. In the same way, if you do B closure, that means we'll be getting BC. Here there are two attributes, that means 2 raised to power 2, or you can say 4 different functional dependencies are possible from this. If I take AB closure, then from this AB closure, you can see we can get ABC. On in this side, we are having 3 attributes, that means 8 different functional dependencies are possible from this. Okay, in the same way, if you take ABC closure, that means you can see that ABC we will get, and there are 3 attributes, therefore we get 8 different functional dependencies which are possible for this. In the same way, like this, phi can determine everything, or A can determine phi, B can determine phi, C can determine phi. So in total, we have total 64 functional dependencies which are possible, but out of these 64 functional dependencies, we have to find which of the functional dependencies is not possible. For example, if I say C can determine A, even though it exists in the additional functional dependency, but this functional dependency is not valid in this case, because if you take C closure, then you will get only C, you will not be able to get A. That is why C determines A is not a valid functional dependency. Okay, in the same way, if I say AC determines B, now this is a valid functional dependency, because just with the help of A you can determine B. So even if I add C, that doesn't create any difference, right? So because if I take AC closure, then I can find A, B, and C, and because there is a B here, so we can say AC determines B is a valid functional dependency. Okay, so we have to find what are the functional dependencies which are valid and what are the functional dependencies which are not valid. That is called as finding additional functional dependencies from the given set of functional dependencies. Okay.